assume, okay, let's say he was elected president, okay? He's entering Jupiter K2. That's a horrible time to be a president during. That's the time of being alone, abandoned. Bernie Sanders, are we gonna feel the burn, or is his campaign gonna go down in flames? That's what we're gonna talk about today in the second video of my AstroPolitics series. You see, we're analyzing four candidates in the Democratic primaries to see who has the strongest chart and who's the most likely to become the Democratic nomination to run against Donald Trump in the 2020 election. In the previous video, we analyzed Kamala Harris. I will also link my part one of this AstroPolitics series, so please check that out. It's going to be in the link below this video. We will be continuing this AstroPolitics series with Elizabeth Warren and Joe Biden. So please check out my continuing videos on this AstroPolitics series. So today we're focusing on Bernie. So I have his chart pulled up right in front of me, and the first thing I notice, he's a Scorpio. That's in Vedic astrology. That's your ascendant, and it's ruled by the planet Mars, so we see he has a lot of ambition there. His Mars, which is his ruling planet, is in the sixth house, which is actually really good, and I'll tell you why, guys. The reason it's good is because Mars is the planet of war. It's the planet of battles. So, believe it or not, even though Bernie Sanders kind of seems like this really meek and humble guy, he has a lot of planetary energy with him to be able to squash his enemies. He has Mars in Aries in his sixth house. So Bernie's been able to, throughout his life, throughout his career, maybe that's why he became a senator of Vermont, was he was able to squash people with his Mars in the sixth house of Aries. So Mars is in its own house, which makes it exceptionally strong. So right there, he has a lot of drive, a lot of ambition. He can crush the enemies. He can also work. He has a lot of energy and drive to pursue his goals. I think he's in his 70s right now, so people are kind of thinking, how is this guy still wanting to run for president? He definitely has that Mars energy behind him, I'll tell you. Now, with a politician, I'm really gonna wanna be looking at his first house. So his first house is pretty strong, especially with the first lord being in Aries. He's identified with conflict. He's identified also with social problems. He wants to try to figure out ways to conquer all these social problems, okay? So that's why he's pretty liberal in his platform. He wants to try to crush all these, poverty. He wants to crush the student loan debt. He wants to crush the big banks. Okay, so that's what we see. Okay, so very strong, pretty strong first house. Now I'm looking at his 10th house. He has the sun in his 10th house and he has Rahu in his 10th house. In Western astrology, Rahu would be the north node of what they call the north node of the moon. In Vedic astrology, Rahu is very symbolic because Rahu's kind of the reason why we choose to reincarnate. It's something that the soul hasn't experienced. So he has the sun in its own house of Leo, the 10th house, and Rahu with it. But what this shows right off the bat, this is a man who craves mostly power, I would say. He craves attention. He craves political power, 10th house. I'm seeing this chart is just showing me, bam, this guy has so much political ambition, even at being at the old age he's at. Sun Rahu in 10th house of Leo. And the sun is in its own house, which makes the sun very strong. This chart is turning out to be a lot more powerful than I even thought. When I actually, before I was even looking at this, literally, I just turned this chart on a few minutes before I started this video. And I was like, boom, like, whoa, this chart, he's very strong. The thing is, though, with this chart, it also might show that this is the drive that led him to become a senator because there's only 100 senators in all of the United States. There's 100 senators and he's one of them, which shows, that's how he got there. So we know he got there with all this strong, powerful chart that he has. The thing that we really want to ask, does he have the current dasha cycles to support him in winning the Democratic nomination and also the run against Donald Trump if he is the Democratic nominee? So I find out, when I look at his chart, I see that he's in Jupiter Mahadasha. Now, Jupiter is the planet of expansion. It's the planet of growth. So it's usually, and it also can be considered the planet of luck. Jupiter is lord of his second house and his fifth house. Okay. Fifth house is luck. Fifth house is God's grace being with you. So that's actually very good. We like that. His Jupiter though is placed in the seventh house of Taurus. And it's in an enemy sign and it's with Saturn. So Jupiter's being constrained there. I'm not seeing that he really has too much luck, too much grace with him at this moment, okay? Because we got to really look at what karma is unfolding in his life right now. We can look at his chart and say, oh, well, he has a very powerful political chart. But we got to see what is the dasha cycle that's really unfolding. So he's in Jupiter Mahadasha, which is the bigger period. But if we want to focus in more, he's in Jupiter Mahadasha, Mercury Bukti. So think of Jupiter Mahadasha as like a book that you have. And these Buktis within the Mahadashas are like little chapters in the book. So he's in Mercury Bukti, which is like a little chapter in that book, okay? He entered Jupiter Mercury on December 2018. And he's going to continue being in this Bukti even up to the presidential election, November 2020, which is very interesting. He's in that, he starts the very end of the Buktis right at around the time of the presidential election. That's very interesting. Let me look more. Okay, so we're going to go see Mercury is really what's his ruling planet right now. So we got to really take a look at Mercury. Now, Mercury is in the 11th house of Virgo. Mercury is mega powerful. Let me tell you, it's exalted in the sign of Virgo. So we know this Mercury Bukti is incredibly strong. Wow, okay. So Mercury is the lord of his 11th house and his 8th house. Okay, that's a little bit of an issue. The 8th house is the house where things get essentially destroyed. So it's very strong 11th house. 11th house means networking. Lots of gains, lots of goals. It's also a very good money house. There might be a lot. He's going to be doing a lot of political fundraising in this time. He's going to be getting a lot of money, a lot of support, probably from his base, his Democratic base, the ones that are his supporters. He's doing a lot of political networking, okay? But the Eighth Lord, Mercury is exalted, so it's a really powerful planet. And it's also the Lord of the Eighth House, which is the planet of transformation, and problems. There can definitely be problems with the eighth house. It can take away things from us. Things can be destroyed with the eighth house. So that's what's making me really go, okay. And then what we got to look at too is to really see if he could become president of the United States, I have to go further, okay? I can't just look at, oh, he's in Jupiter Mercury in you know, November of 2020. He enters Jupiter K2 in March of 2021. So we have to assume, okay, let's say he was elected president, okay? He's entering Jupiter K2. That's a horrible time to be a president during. That's the time of alone, abandon. K2 is the Karaka of cutting things off from us. And so I don't know if I see a presidency run here. I think Bernie's gonna make it very far in the Democratic nomination process. However, I'm not seeing him being able to defeat Donald Trump at all. He's going to be in K2, which is the time of endings. Things are being ripped apart, okay? Also, there's not a dasha running with his 10th house. Now, his 10th house looks pretty strong. It has the sun in Leo in the 10th house, but that dasha is not running. So when we're looking at Vedic astrology, we have to see what dasha is running. Guys, I don't think he's going to make the Democratic nomination. He's going to get very close. It might end up like what happened last time with Hillary, where he gets really close. but he just quite doesn't make it. He quite doesn't have the support. He's going to be very visible during this whole process. So he's going to be one of the top two, top three contenders for this. So out of the four, Bernie's going to be up there. He's going to be in the top two for this Democratic nomination. Definitely he cannot defeat Trump, because I'm seeing the Jupiter K2 in March 2021. I just don't see how would you get elected president in January of 2021 and then all of a sudden be entering K2 boopty. That doesn't make sense to me at all. So there you have it. Bernie Sanders has a very strong political chart. However, this is not the time for you, Bernie. I'm sorry about it. As a Vedic astrologer, my advice would be, you know, keep up the good fight. But it looks like fate is not on your side. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel so that you can keep informed with all this Vedic astrology we're doing with all these candidates. Thank you so much for watching.